Buongiorno, guten Tag, hello everybody. We are here today at the German-Italian Center for European Dialogue, Villa Vigoni, together with Professor Klaus Stierstorfer, Professor for British Studies at the University of Münster in Germany. And Professor Stierstorfer is also a Vereinsmitglied, socio dell'associazione, so a member of the association Villa Vigoni, and he is currently coordinating a conference here at the Villa Vigoni, which is an event which is part of a symposium organized by University of Münster's Collaborative Research Center, 1385, Law and Literature, here at the Villa Vigoni. The event is taking place from the 13th of September until the 16th of September 2021. And in different panel discussions, experts from law and literature are addressing future perspectives on Europe from an interdisciplinary point of view. So, Professor Klaus Stierstorfer, I would like to give you the floor and just to explain us a little bit what's going on during this conference here at the Villa Vigoni, Law and Literature.
Well, thank you very much for this opportunity. It's of course a great privilege and pleasure to be here in Villa Vigoni, as always. This time we bring the main research project on law and literature, which is formatted in Münster within a collaborative research center funded by the German Research Council. And here in Villa Vigoni, we set ourselves the task to explore new perspectives and visions, perhaps even, of Europe, which the interdisciplinary work between law and literature can put together. Obviously, law and literature are closely tied together. That's at least our belief, our thesis, which we try to realize in our research. And quite obviously for many people as well, both law and literature as well form central and important pillars of what we think Europe is all about. It is founded in legal convictions and processes, and it is also founded in stories and literatures of various kinds. I think that has also been researched in various contexts in legal and literary studies. What we try to do innovatively is to bring the two together and see what, and some would even say interdiscipline of law and literature, can say innovatively about Europe, how legal concepts are influenced and sometimes even framed or shaped by literary lines of tradition, and conversely, how literary contexts can bring about new literary formations in long-term processes, but of course very specifically with a view to the major challenges facing Europe at the moment. And we haven't finished yet, so I can't tell you yet a lot about the results we'll have, but I'm sure we'll look forward to publishing them and look forward to staying in touch with researchers worldwide about this interesting approach. Part of the project work we do here is actually quite outreaching and public, as we have joined in the initiative of the Conference of Europe, launched some time ago by the European Presidency, the European Council, and as a sort of European Citizens Initiative in contributing to a future vision of what Europe could be or how Europe could evolve in the future. So we will have a public Zoom event where everyone, I'm almost saying worldwide, but certainly European-wide, can join in and can enter our discussion with important input statements from mainly with a focus on human rights, among others by Lord Mans, a member of the House of Lords in Britain, as well as Lady Arden, a Supreme Court judge in Great Britain, and formerly a sitting judge in the Strasbourg European Court, and other contributors on law and literature. So this is another opportunity for us to reach out and get into discussions with a wider public on the issues we address in our research project.